In the policeman's car, it had LoJack, and the thief boldly parked it behind a police station, where it was recovered, and he was arrested. So you see, not every thief is real lucky. LoJack is the only stolen vehicle recovery system used by the police. Nationally, stolen vehicles that have LoJack are recovered over 90% of the time. For more information, call your car dealer or 1-888-26-LOJACK. LoJack helps the police help you.
It's 10:01 at News Jersey. Construction crews accidentally digging into a natural gas line in Edison this morning forced a four-block evacuation by Turnpike Exit 10. No one reported hurt, no fire or anything. But wasn't it in Edison that that horrendous explosion resulted from a gas leak a few years ago? So police were scrambling for a while. Once again, it was a construction crew making a mistake. It wasn't supposed to happen anymore, was it? Not a major power outage, but with the heat, it's a sticky one. GPU crews putting the finishing touches on transformer repairs in Englishtown. Around 150 families without electricity overnight. The reason?
Damage due to transformers by animal contact. There were about approximately 100 to 150 people out of service, and all are back in service but one.
GPU spokeswoman Donna Lindemeyer says the damaged transformers were replaced, not repaired. The Jersey legislature is taking another look at that new contract to put up inspection lanes for the enhanced auto emissions testing. Senate President Donald DeFrancesco calling for a special meeting of the Senate Legislative Oversight Committee to review the contract. Police in Newark investigating a morning corpse dumped on a street this morning. Body of a woman they think was murdered somewhere else, dumped out of a car in downtown Newark. State regulators meeting again in Newark this morning, assessing progress toward that fabled free enterprise deregulation of Jersey's local telephone market. Stock traders on Wall Street watching prices closely in the early going of trading after yesterday's record close on the Dow. At last check, the Dow was down a few points, maybe 8 or 9 points, still considerably above 9,300. News Jersey time, 10:03. That nickel-a-gallon gas tax increase in jeopardy. I'll explain after New Jersey 101.5 fast traffic.
Well, you might see some police activity around the Union tolls of the Garden State Parkway. We have just gotten a preliminary report that there may have been a robbery of one of the toll clerks on the Garden State Parkway right at the Union Toll Plaza. So police are on the scene there. That's going to cause delays for drivers, no doubt. So you can expect some delays north and southbound. But again, this is at the Union tolls of the Garden State Parkway. Other than that, the Garden State Parkway in fairly decent shape. No reported problems on the New Jersey Turnpike. Now, over on 295 southbound, we do have an accident involving two tractor trailers coming in through Swedesboro. That's southbound 295 in through that area. A couple of tractor trailers collided. Also, Route 70 and 72, an accident at the 4 Mile Circle in Southampton. No reported problems at the Delaware River crossings. I'm happy to report the Hudson River crossings have calmed down. Route 287 looks good in both directions, and New Jersey Transit SEPTA trains running on time. That's New Jersey Fast Traffic, sponsored by A&P. A&P announces the grand reopening of their new Bloomfield store at 19 Bellevue Avenue in Bloomfield. Stop by and see the many ways you can save at A&P. Check out the savings shop at A&P. New Jersey Fast Traffic, every 15 minutes around the clock. I'm Jay Trelease. Next report, 10:18 on New Jersey 101, New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey 101.5 News Time, 10:05. Assembly Speaker Jack Collins is answering some of the political criticism about that increase in the gasoline tax. Governor Whitman proposing a nickel-a-gallon increase to replenish the state's transportation infrastructure repair fund. Collins warns that the majority Republicans in the legislature are not going to bear full responsibility for raising these taxes.
If there is not a good deal of Democratic support, there will not be a continuation of the transportation trust fund.
In other words, the gasoline tax. Governor Whitman continues to lobby heavily for the money. She travels several times a week to some dilapidated bridge or overburdened stretch of Jersey Highway. New pine trees sprouting in parts of Jersey. Very suspicious looking pine trees. Cellular phone companies have started disguising some of their towers as either trees or windmills. What's going on? Bell Atlantic Mobile spokesman Howard Waterman.
Typically, if there's a pine tree site going up, you know, in a town, they've asked for it. So I think that typically we've had pretty positive results.
Waterman says Bell Atlantic Mobile's erected three camouflaged cell towers in New Jersey. He estimates there are less than 10 statewide so far. Private doctors in Jersey observing what they call Patients' Bill of Rights Day. Actually, it was yesterday. Dr. Gregory Sachs, head of the Medical Society of New Jersey, announced at a statehouse rally,
"Our campaign seeks to secure federal legislation to give our patients a greater voice and more control in decisions affecting their health care.
Among other things, the Medical Society wants you to have the right to sue your health carrier if it denies you benefits." New Jersey 101.5 News Time, 10:06. The complete Alan Casper, New Jersey forecast next.
Is your time valuable? Of course it is. So consider this. It takes only minutes to make a mistake you'll live with for years. It takes even less time to make absolutely sure you're paying less for that new car or truck at the Flemington Car and Truck Country family of dealerships on routes 202 and 31 in Flemington, New Jersey. We're inviting you to test price the best before you buy anything anywhere. And nowhere else can you browse, shop, and compare 23 brands of new cars and trucks at genuinely lower prices every day. Ford, Lincoln, Mercury, Nissan, BMW, Chevrolet, Geo, Isuzu, Pontiac, Subaru, Mitsubishi, Chrysler, Plymouth, Dodge, Jeep, Eagle, Mazda Infiniti, Buick, GMC Truck, Volkswagen, Porsche, Audi, and now over 350 quality used cars and trucks. The Flemington Car and Truck Country family of dealerships are looking forward to seeing you. You won't waste your time or your money, but we'll show you just how easy it is to get a better price and how good you'll feel doing it. The Flemington Car and Truck Country family of dealerships. It's 202 and 31, where you expect to pay less.
Define excellence in healthcare? The St. Barnabas Healthcare System. With 10 outstanding hospitals and 48 facilities throughout New Jersey, we're the state's largest healthcare system, offering internationally and nationally recognized programs that set the standard for clinical excellence. Our world-renowned scientific and medical teams are pioneering today's most promising infertility treatments. Our renal transplant centers are among the most active in America. And our pediatric and adult cancer centers provide patients with the newest treatments available. We offer the state's most comprehensive range of cardiac services for children and adults. And we are at the forefront in emergency services, burn care, and neurosurgery. All this and more means we're setting a standard for advanced care in virtually every field of medicine. For more information, visit our website at stbarnabas.com or call us at 1-888-SBHS-123.
The opinions expressed by the host, callers, and guests are not those of New Jersey 101.5 Press Communications, LLC, or station advertisers. Calls may be taped and edited for use in station promotional announcements or later broadcasts. Listeners are limited to one call every 30 days.
New Jersey 101.5 News Time, 10:08. New Jersey 101.5 Instant Weather.
Today, changeable skies or clouds and some sun and very, very humid. A shower or gusty thunderstorm can pop up, especially this afternoon or this evening. Some highs could reach 90 to 95, the warmest reading, as has been the case lately, Lakehurst and Ocean County. After the chance of a shower or a thunderstorm early this evening, we'll have some clearing overnight, gradually drying out, 65 to 75 for statewide lows. Looks like a terrific weekend and much less humid tomorrow with some sunshine, some patchy clouds, most highs in the 80s. And Sunday, sunshine, moderate humidity, 85 to 90, but lower near the ocean. Again, changeable skies and humid today. Watch for a shower or thunderstorm chance. Some highs 90 to 95 this afternoon and much drier for the weekend, especially tomorrow. That's New Jersey 101.5 weather. I'm meteorologist Alan Casper.
Clifton, 83. East Windsor, 79. Cape May, 82. New Jersey instant weather every 10 minutes on New Jersey 101.5. Next scheduled news, Jersey at 11 o'clock. For Mary Jo Powell, I'm Nick Alexander with New Jersey's 24-hour broadcast news team.
New Jersey 101.5, our own radio station. Not New York, not Philadelphia. Proud to be New Jersey. New Jersey 101.5.
1-800-283-101.5. Call 1-800-283-101.5.
New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey, Chime Time is 10:10. Hi there, I'm Roberta Gale, and I'm in for Dennis and Judy. They're going to be back on Monday, and I'm going on vacation next week, and then after that, things ought to sort of, like, settle down to something that sort of is around normal. Anyway, the phone number here, 1-800-283-101.5. And, you know, the other day, I had these friends take me out on a small boat, like a 16-foot boat with a... you know, I don't know what horsepower motor it is, okay? excuse me, but it was a motor. You know, I'm like so non-nautical, bow, stern, you know, this, tack, I have no idea. All I know is like 16-foot boat. There was my husband and I and my friend and her husband. And we went on the Delaware for about an hour, hour and a half. And it was at twilight. And it was absolutely gorgeous. It was just so quiet. And then, like, you round these bends, you know, as you go up the Delaware, like, around, you know, Stockton or Frenchtown or other or whatever. And you know what? It looks like, okay, I wasn't there, but it looks like the way that it must have been hundreds of years ago. I mean, it just looks like the same. I kept thinking of the settlers, you know, with their little canal boats and the poles and all this, and it was very, very cool. Part of the reason it was so quiet and so wonderful, except for the part where we got to go under this, like, these major electric wires, and then you could hear the noise, and it was really scary, and I made them go faster, is because there were no jet skis. Because all the little kids had to be in at twilight, because it's dangerous to go under jet skis, and they have to have their dinner. Now, you know how I feel about jet skiers. And jet skiers, boaters hate them, swimmers hate them, a lot of people hate them. Because the majority of people who ride jet skis, the majority, not all, are horses' asses. And they annoy everybody, they buzz people, and because they don't have the skills, and they're too scared, and they're too weeny, they want to stay right along the shore, or in my case, you know, like the Delaware, like a river instead of a bay or the ocean, they go like, they're right in front of their dock. They keep buzzing, you know, within a couple hundred yards of their dock. Back and forth and back and forth and back. You know, to me, that's a neon sign that says, I'm a weenie, I have no guts. Well, just the other day, and you know, I've also talked about the fact that for the number of jet skis in New Jersey, the proportion of accidents is like so much higher than the number of jet skis. It's just incredible. Yesterday afternoon, a 13-year-old from Toms River died after a head-on collision between two personal watercraft, jet skis, whatever you want to call them. I know the jet skis are a product name and personal watercraft, but, you know, near Berkeley Island County Park. What happened was two personal watercraft were being used by three kids, okay? Two were the drivers, one was a passenger. One of the kids was celebrating his birthday. What a way to celebrate your birthday, huh? Right before the head-on collision, in which the kid, I believe, was killed instantly, one of the drivers cut power to the engine because he saw that he was going to hit the guy on the other jet ski. And remember, we're talking about 13 and 14-year-old kids here, okay? He cut the power to the engine because he saw this head-on collision coming. It caused the front end of the jet ski to dip into the water, and it caused the other jet ski to go over the front of his watercraft, and then, poof, death. The other kid, the 13-year-old, was dead. The 14-year-old was taken to the hospital for an injured knee. Now, the 14-year-old had one of those certification cards for operating personal watercraft. The cops didn't know, as of yesterday, yesterday, whether or not the dead kid had one. So what we have here is, and by the way, according to cops, an emergency stopping of the engine of jet skis or personal watercraft is the worst possible thing to do. They said you have to leave the gas on so you could steer out of trouble. Once you cut the engine, there's no steering on that thing. Either the kid didn't know, or he was just scared, or he was just too young. But now what we have is three kids, two 14, one 13. One 13-year-old dead. One 14-year-old was celebrating his birthday. He had an injured knee. All because they were on stupid jet skis that go fast, and they didn't know how to operate them properly, even with one of them having that stupid little worthless card that any kid that goes to high school or junior high could pass that course. And I'd like to propose this, because, I look at this all the time. I see jet skis all the time. Granted, I don't live near the shore or the bay, but living near the river, it's something that I encounter just about every day in the warm weather. You have to be 16 to get a learner's permit to drive. And as you know, they're changing the rules, so you're going to have graduated licensing, and you won't be able to get a full license until you're 18 years old to drive a car. And yet, you have 13 and 14-year-olds driving these personal watercraft that can go very, very, very fast, faster than most people drive some cars. I don't think that anyone under 18, with or without that stupid little useless certification, should be able to operate jet skis. I mean, you gotta be a parent that has no brain in your stupid little punk imbecile head to let your 13 and 14-year-old operate something so fast. Now, yes, I... All right, look. I know kids have dirt bikes sometimes or all-terrain vehicles or whatever, but those are usually... I'm not saying those are great either, and I wouldn't let my kid do it. But then again, I'm a weenie mom. A lot of times you're out in the middle of nowhere with those things, and you don't run into swimmers or, you know, other people in canoes or whatever. Jet skis, I think, are totally dangerous. And, you know, we talked about this last week when I was working for Dominski and Doyle, in the sense that I think that they should have been banned from all waters, or you need to at least set certain areas to have jet skis. Now, I know that national parks and are thinking by next year they want to ban all jet skis. They're sick of the noise, the danger. They can't handle it. It ruins everyone's time. I'm going to go further in proposing that rather than just have a place set aside for jet skis, because I'm not saying people should. There's no reason why responsible adults should not be allowed to jet ski. Okay? However, I just think that no one under 18 should be allowed to ride a jet ski. Now, I'm not saying that at that magic age of 18 that, you know, you're going to be all of a sudden, gee, I'm a responsible adult. No. But, I mean, all the time I see teenagers on these things and they act like idiots. 1-800-283-101.5. That's 1-800-283-101.5. Christine from Whiting, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, how are you?
Okay, honey.
I just have a comment about that. I had my watercraft certification last year.
Right.
When they made it mandatory in July.
Right.
Now, before that, the year before that, when they were putting it into effect, anybody was allowed to go.
Right.
So this made 10, 11, 12, 13-year-olds allowed to get this permit.
Right.
Now you have to be, if I'm right, 15 or 16. But it's still, that's dangerous.
Okay, but also, here's another thing, though. You know, you look at cops that sit around and ticket people for going 5, 10 miles over the hour in a zone that probably you should be going faster in anyway. And yet, rules like this are never enforced. I mean, I don't understand why you can't have, you know, cops or, well, it's not really Coast Guard, let's say where I am on the river, but, you know, in the oceans or bays, Coast Guard, why you can't have more people enforcing that law, and when you see a 12, 13, 14-year-old on a jet ski, you yank them off.
Yeah, you're right. I went down the Matitakong. I watched a 15-year-old on one of the stand-up jet skis.
Yeah.
Almost hit us and hit another guy.
Yeah, and the thing is, Christine, come on. You and I know. You're 23 years old. Mm-hmm. I mean, even as a female, you probably didn't even start maturing yourself till you were 17 or 18. And we all know women mature faster than men. A boy is still a boy until he's in his late 20s, as far as I'm concerned. And certainly a kid 14, 15, 16 is going to act like a little boy jerk.
Yeah, but the thing is, these kids don't understand there's a time to have fun and there's a time to watch out on the water.
Right, and they don't know. And I'll tell you something. Any parent, if you're a parent that lets your young kid on a jet ski because the laws aren't enforced, you're an idiot. I'm sorry, you're a flat-out imbecile idiot. And I'm sure that the parent that's sitting there grieving and crying today because their 13-year-old kid was offed instantly on a jet ski in a head-on collision by three schmucky kids, all 14 or under, I bet you he would have said, you know what? I shouldn't have let the kid on the jet ski. 1019 at New Jersey 101.5. More of your calls in just a minute right now. Here's fast traffic.
Well, southbound 295, slow traffic coming in through Swedesboro. An accident there involving a couple of tractor trailers. Also, Route 70 and 72, accident at the 4 Mile Circle being reported. The Garden State Parkway, we had a report of a possible police investigation. Apparently, a toll clerk was robbed on the Garden State Parkway right at the Union Tolls. So expect delays in both directions. Over on the Turnpike, we seem to be faring well. Northbound Truck Route 109 in pretty good shape. The Pulaski Skyway, though, southbound heavy in through Route 109 and then slow down through Route 78 with long-term construction. Also, the Route 109 ramp to westbound Route 78 shut down until September with construction. No problems reported at the Hudson River crossings. The Delaware River crossings in pretty good shape, and New Jersey Transit SEPTA trains running on time. New Jersey fast traffic every 15 minutes around the clock. I'm Jay Trelease. Next report, 10:33 on New Jersey 101, New Jersey 101.5.
So I just heard him say that a toll collector was robbed. I mean, in a way, isn't it poetic justice? Because nobody ever announces on the air how many times we're robbed from paying tolls, you know? New Jersey traffic is sponsored by the Mart, just 3 days left, and the incredible Mart Furniture Gallery's going out of business sale, Route 35 in Middletown. Everything must go, final 2 days, Saturday and Sunday until 7. I'm sorry, 18 and under should not be on a jet ski. Okay, unless there is a parent with them. And, you know, look, I'm not being hypocritical because, you know, I talk about the type of thing that, you know, especially boys and men have become like total gutless weenies. I mean, just no stones at all. And, you know, people have to have a helmet. They have to live in a plastic bubble. They don't do anything that's manly or gutsy or they can get just scraped up a little. Okay, I understand that part. But if you're doing a dirt bike or an all-terrain vehicle, or if you're out in the middle of the ocean with a jet ski, fine. But jet skis, you're staying near shore, you're staying around people, you're around a bunch of other jet skis and swimmers and people and other boats and non-motorized boats. And I'm sorry, you're an idiot parent if you let your kid on a jet ski alone, number one. Number two, nobody under 18 should be on them. And I say nobody, let's face it, it's mostly young males. It's a young male thing. And it's a death trap. And yet you need to be at least 16 to have a driver's license, and they're even changing that because it's too young, that you have to be 18 to have a full license in the future. 1-800-283-101.5. Richard from Tom's River. Hi, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
How you doing? I'm calling about how you talk about that certificate being nothing. It's nothing more, just like your driver's license, nothing more. It's an awareness course. I'm 53, and I just passed that last week. In a sense of passing it, is not mandatory like a driver's license that you're monitored and that strict monitor that if you don't have the answers, you don't get your license. But the awareness course is important to know about the waterways and how to operate a machine like that.
No, I understand that, but Richard, especially for you, you're 53 years old. Yep. The older we get, the harder it is to learn things or you learn new things. A young kid can take that course, memorize it because they're in school, used to going to school, and it can go through one ear and out the other. I mean, I'm sorry. In that sense, it's useless. I think what we need to do is increase the age, and like I said, it's not like you're going to go, well, I'm 18, I'm a young male, no, I'm like totally responsible. I mean, let's face it. You know, I love you guys. I adore men. Life would be nothing without men. But on the other hand, men do not stop getting like dumb and dorky until they're like in their late 20s. Steve, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
I have to disagree with you.
Okay.
Men are terrific guys.
What?
Men are wonderful.
And what did I just say?
Listen.
I said, what did I, wait a minute, I want you to repeat what I said. What did I say? Didn't I?
Men are dorky until they're 21.
Right, but then what did I say after that?
You adore them and they're wonderful.
All right, come on, let's get real.
But listen, the problem with the Jersey Shore is they take all the riders and they confine them into one small area, maybe 1,000 square yards.
Right.
And then, yeah, everybody goes crazy, they go as fast as they possibly can, and they run into each other. If they would spread that out, we go to St. Martin every year and my kids are on jet skis. And they don't go near each other.
How old are your kids?
They're 16, 17, and 19.
And when did they start jet skiing?
About 2 years ago.
I got to tell you, Steve, I think it's an irresponsible parent that lets a young kid alone. But
it's
with them, like, okay, on another jet ski, or are you with them as a passenger?
I'm with them as a passenger. Sometimes I'm next to them. Like, when they first started out, they were with me as a passenger. They were with me, I was with them, I let them drive it for a while, until they got used to it.
Tell me something, your kid's smart enough to know that when you're about to have a head-on collision, you never cut the engine so that you can steer away from it?
Yes, they were taught all that stuff. First of all, they're not even close to head-on collisions because I don't let them go near each other. They don't have games.
But you know what, Steve? I know that in certain areas in the state that they're confined, but on some bays, and certainly where I am in my river, in Delaware River and other rivers, there's no area to confine them. And, you know, yeah, they pretty much zip up and down, and they buzz tubers and canoers and other boaters and even, you know, people with small horsepower engines and things, and it's, like, so dangerous. I see these people peel out all the time and get hurt.
That's right.
I, you know, Steve.
And the problem is everybody's too confined. If they would spread out and get away from each other, there wouldn't be any head-on collisions, there wouldn't be any problems.
Well, the thing is, look, I don't mind, like, at the shore, 1,000 feet, you know, maybe that's not enough. They can make it a bigger place. But the thing is, most jet skiers are scared little boys who like to just either hang with the pack or the kind of guys I see on the Delaware River that never want to go off away from the pier because they're too damn scared. 1-800-283-101.5. I mean, look, yes, I think there's a place for jet skis, even though they're not my thing. That's fine. I got to admit that there's a place for that. People are different than me. People like a charge. People like fast. I like to drive cars fast. You know, that's fine. Fast, there's nothing wrong with it. But I'm sorry. Little kids drive 13 and 14-year-olds. And I've even seen a kid, I swear to God, he looked no older than 10, alone on a jet ski in the river. You know, where's people enforcing laws here? You know, I get popped for going 10 miles over the speed limit in my car, But then some schmuck can let his a kid that looks like 10 ride a jet ski that he could barely put the handles on, and I saw the kid peel out. 1-800-283-101.5. Mike from Florence, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Okay, dear.
I'm laughing because you're half right and you're half wrong on this. I have three kids.
Yeah.
And, we all took the license course together, and my youngest was 9 when we did it. And it was my daughter, and, you know, it's like anything else. The parents have to be smart. They have to know what the deal is, and they have to have an idea, you know, what these things are and what they're not. And we go out, and we use them, we have a good time, and we're all together, but we're very careful. And
okay, but let me ask him, like, the 9-year-old, at what age would you let her ride a jet ski by herself?
Well, she's been riding now for 2 years.
By herself?
Right, and she rides by herself. I am usually with her or on the other jet ski by her. We find a nice, quiet park in the bay where there's nobody around, and we have a great time.
Mike, I have to tell you something now. I mean, don't you think, I mean, looking at it, try to look at this objectively, okay? And you sound like a balanced guy, and I don't expect you to totally agree with me, nor vice versa. But when you look at this, how can you be on a separate jet ski when your little 9-year-old is on a jet ski?
Well, there's a couple of things that happen. One, we use hand signals to talk to each other. There's a lot of things that people do if they know what they're doing.
Yeah, I understand that, but Mike,
in contact all the time,
Mike, that head-on collision took a split second.
And I'm not. Listen, I know how dangerous they are, I don't disagree that young kids are an issue here. I'm just telling you that it can work if it's working.
Mike, I'm just telling you, and you know, I know that when we hang up, you can think I'm an idiot and tell me to go to hell, but I think it's abusive of a parent to have a child that young alone on a jet ski if you love your kid. Okay? I beg to differ, but I think it's child abuse. 1-800-283-101.5. Fine, you want your kid under 18. Here's what I think. Yeah, if you want your kid under 18 on a jet ski, you have to go with them as a passenger. The same rules that are going to happen with these progressive driver's licenses where you can't get the full driver's license until you're 18. I don't think it's a big deal, and I don't think I'm being a nut, and I'm still admitting, fine, you want a jet ski. You got to go fast. You're insecure. You're a speed freak. You like a Russian like. You don't think life is enough tumult and turmoil. Fine, go ahead.
New Jersey 101.5 invites you to start the weekend the Big Joe Henry way.
First, break the lawnmower so you won't have to worry about that the rest of the weekend. Second, you'll want to ice down an adequate amount of your favorite beverage.
Here's the ice truck you ordered, Mr. Henry.
Third, toss some food on the grill. Then just crank up the oldies, the Friday Night Jersey Oldies Show, baby. The best music ever made.
The Friday Night Jersey Oldies Show with Big Joe Henry.
Ooh, 50 pounds of ground beef.
Weekends never sounded so good. New Jersey 101.5.
The following is a paid commercial announcement.
Hi, honey, what are you doing?
We're just reading this article about the new trash tax in New Jersey.
Oh, boy, that sounds interesting. Hey, I didn't know we had a trash tax in New Jersey.
Well, we don't yet. Some state politicians want to pass a bill that forces local governments to charge us a trash tax. And that's going to raise our property tax.
Wait a minute. You mean we're going to pay more property tax to take care of trash? Don't we already pay a pretty high trash fee every month?
According to the article, the counties need the trash tax to pay off a lot of bad debts they piled up after years of mistakes and mismanagement of trash disposal. The state shares a lot of the blame, too, according to this.
So let me get this straight. Homeowners like us are already paying high rates for trash disposal. And now, because of someone else's mistakes, the legislature wants to hit us with a new trash tax and raise our property tax? I don't think so.
To stop the new trash tax, call your state senator today. Then call us toll-free at 877-TRASH-TX, paid for by the Coalition to Stop the Trash Tax.
The following is paid for by the working men and women of the AFL-CIO.
I love nursing, but it's so much harder than it's ever been.
She's been a nurse for more than 20 years, and over those years, Lynn Pius has seen our healthcare system change. Today, in the new world of HMOs and managed care, nurses and doctors are no longer free to pursue the best treatments or even to give patients their best advice.
These bureaucrats from the insurance company, they routinely deny care, and they make decisions that only the doctors should be making.
The proposed Patient Bill of Rights Act would address these abuses and put decisions that affect our lives back where they belong, in the hands of medical professionals. But our representative, Michael Pappas, has failed to endorse this law, and the insurance industry is spending millions to defeat it. Call Congressman Pappas at 1-800-378-1844 and tell him to support the Patient Bill of Rights.
If Congress would just do their job, then I can do mine.
Freehold Mitsubishi has just solved your car buying problem, but only for a short time. You can acquire a new or used factory warranted car or truck for only a $29 acquisition fee. Pay only $29 and just make the payments on the car of your dreams. At Freehold Mitsubishi, you can own or lease a fabulous new car or truck, late model used, barely driven demo, company car, lease expired vehicle, or even a pre-owned 4x4 for the unbelievable acquisition fee of just $29. And just make the payments. But hurry. Time's a-wastin'. Choose from Jeep, Ford, Dodge, Honda, Toyota, Nissan, Mitsubishi, Hyundai. Practically every make and model. Don't miss this $29 opportunity at Freehold Mitsubishi's $29 acquisition sales event. Time is not on your side. Hurry for the best selection. Credit problems are no problem. Pay only $29 and just make the payments at Freehold Mitsubishi. Call now for complete details. 732-780-9500. Plus tax, tags, and registration fees with approval by primary lender. See Weekend Asbury Park Press for complete details.
New Jersey 101.5, instant weather, changeable skies and humid. Now watch for shower or thunderstorm, 90 to 95, believe it or not. Tonight, chance of an early shower or thunderstorm, then clearing 65 to 75 over the weekend. Much less humid. Thank God. A little bit of sun, highs in the 80s, and Sunday sunny with moderate humidity, 85 to 90, lower near the ocean. Phillipsburg 80, Wall Township 80, Linwood 80. Next New Jersey weather, 10 minutes away on New Jersey 101.5, serving Atlantic City and Cape May on 97.3 FM. I'm Roberta Gale, in for Dennis and Judy. The phone number 1-800-283-101.5. Let me tell you something. You may as well, if you're going to let a 9-year-old kid alone on a jet ski, you may as well just take a gallon of gasoline, pour it over her little body, and light a cigarette. I mean, I think parents who allow their kids to do really stupid, dangerous things should not somehow legally be allowed to grieve when they die. I was talking about a kid died yesterday afternoon, 13-year-old, on a jet ski near Berkeley Island County Park, Berkeley Township. Head-on collision with a 14-year-old. They didn't know what the hell to do. Debbie from Buena, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, Roberta, how you doing?
Hi, honey.
I had a 15-year-old son that had an accident on a jet ski 9 years ago before there was any regulations at all. I didn't even know what a jet ski was.
Right.
And he broke both of his legs. So, and he was in the hospital for a long time. They had to do a lot of different things to him. He's 26 now, and he's fine. But I think they're really dangerous. And
now, wait a minute. Why did you... You said you didn't even know what a jet ski was. I mean, isn't it your responsibility as a parent to know what your kid is buying?
Oh, absolutely. Well, he didn't buy it. They went and rented them.
Without your permission?
Yep.
See, that's another thing. I also think when you rent them, you should be like, how? All right, here's the deal, Debbie. You need to be, in most places, 25 to be able to rent a car, right? Or
right.
21, or, you know, depending on the place.
Yep.
Why shouldn't you have to be, say, 21 to rent a jet ski?
I don't know.
Or have parental permission.
That's what I wanted to know when the police called me and told me that my son was in an accident, and I had no idea he was even there.
Did he ever go on a jet ski again?
No.
Yeah, I didn't think so, Debbie. Thank you, honey. I'm glad he's okay. It's 10:33 at New Jersey 101.5. More calls in a minute. Right now, here's fast traffic.
We have minor delays on the New Jersey Turnpike, southbound through Interchange 5 with right lane construction. The lanes are coned off, and as I said, minor delays. No problems on the parkway over on southbound 295 in through Swedesboro. An accident involving two tractor trailers. Only the left lane is open. Minor delays reported in Voorhees. Southbound 73 with an accident at Crescent Road. Eastbound Whitman Bridge is slow on the upside with construction. The westbound Ben Franklin Bridge is slow into the toll plaza. No problems at the Hudson River crossings. Route 287 in pretty good shape. And New Jersey Transit SEPTA trains running on time. That's New Jersey Fast Traffic, sponsored by Just Tires. Just Tires presents Famous Time Savers. The year 1980, the first dial-a-date phone service pops up in California. Just Tires, home of the 30-minute installation guarantee, or you get 20% off. New Jersey Fast Traffic, every 15 minutes around the clock. I'm Jay Trelease. Next report, 1048 on New Jersey 101, New Jersey 101.5.
You know, I'm still blown away by that guy who let it. I mean, he just sounded so lucid and responsible, but he let his 9-year-old kid alone on a jet ski. He says, well, I'm on another jet ski sometimes. We have hand signals. Yeah, I got a hand signal for you, pal, and it ain't waving hello. You know? I mean, why? Oh, I'm going to give my 9-year-old a jet ski. Well, gee, why don't you just make it faster? Why don't you just take a fully loaded Glock, press it to her little temple, and then press the trigger? You know? I'm sorry. John from Eatontown, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, I have the actual navigation rules right in front of me, and it says every vessel shall at all times proceed at a safe speed so that she can take proper and effective action to avoid collision and be stopped within a distance appropriate to the prevailing circumstances and conditions.
Well, you know, it also says in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not kill, but you people know, kill. I mean...
The thing with these jet skis is, in the sense of the immaturity of little kids, is that they don't understand all these details of these very specific rules. And jet skis, and the problem with them is that they have no under-the-keel rudder, so when you take power off of the engine...
By the way, what's the keel? Because I don't know all the nautical stuff.
It's the very bottom of the boat.
Okay.
Like an outboard has something that protrudes below the...
Oh, right. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. It almost looks like a bottom fish fin or something.
Yeah, and the same thing with an inboard engine or an inboard outboard.
And that gives it stability.
No, it gives it some steering ability when you take off power. When you reduce power.
Oh, right. See, that was with his head-on collision. They said the problem was the kid cut off the power. There was no steering at all.
Yeah, and the other ridiculousness and idiocy of these little kids using these things is that when you use full power and the throttle's completely, at full power, if you need to turn, you have no more power to turn. So if you operate at a safe speed at a very reduced power, when you need to turn in emergency with a jet ski, you could increase power suddenly and lean in a direction.
Well, you know, John, I think that's why I think, look, I see, you know, where I go by the river, I mean, I see plenty of idiots who are over 18 and over 21 riding jet skis. But the difference is, you figure, you know what? They're adults. If they're going to kill themselves or even me, hey, at least we're of age and making some kind of decision here. When it's a parent allowing a child as young as 9, I'm sorry. I mean, that's almost like, that's like murder in a really weird way. I mean, it's potential. I don't know. I don't get it. I don't get it. No, you know, I don't want a kid to grow up to be a total weenie and living in a little fishbowl or living in a plastic bubble or something like that, or like having helmets head to toe and they can't go out and even pass gas without wearing a helmet or something like that. No, I think kids need to get scraped up once in a while and all that, but not on something that can go faster than most people drive a car. And come on. So, I think you need to be, if you're 18 or under, you need to have an adult as a passenger. This is my rules. This is Roberta rules. On a jet ski. 1-800-283-101.5. Chris from PA, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, Roberta. How are you today?
Okay, Chris.
I just have a couple comments I'd like to make on it. From Harvey's Lake, Pennsylvania, we have a small natural lake that has a lot of residents on it.
Yeah.
And it doesn't just stop at the young children on jet skis. It's also the adults that are totally out of control because of how these machines have been manufactured. I've ridden them myself. I do not personally own one at this time, but friends have them. And we've seen a lot of injuries between adults, between 25 and 45 years.
But see, I'll tell you something. I can't blame the machine. I blame the operator. People take dumb chances with these things, and because they want to go fast and they want to rush, and because, you know, their job at the gas station's really boring and they want a little rush in the rest of their life.
I definitely agree.
You know?
When it comes down to the child, I didn't hear about that tragic accident because I do live in northern Pennsylvania. But we've had accidents recently in Wilkes-Barre itself where a young girl, 14 years old, on a mountain bike, went over the handlebars and broke her neck. Just a freak accident.
Now,
it happens everywhere.
Yeah, Chris, and I'm not saying you need to stop everything, you know, some kid got killed biking, so we need to outlaw bikes. No, but when you look at the number of accidents on jet skis versus the number of accidents, I mean, per jet ski or per bicycle, the accident rate for bicycles is a lot lower.
Oh, definitely.
All right, thanks a lot. And there's more, you know what the problem is, because of the speed. There's more of a potential to hurt everybody else. And you know what? I'm sorry. You know, I just got married for the first time in my life at 40. For God's sake, I'm enjoying my life, okay? I don't want to be tubing down the river and have, and like be offed and end my life prematurely because some 10-year-old imbecile was their parents purchased a jet ski for him or her, and they're sitting there going 35 miles an hour right into me.
New Jersey 101.5.
Driving home in the late afternoon.
Tune in for weather.
Meteorologist Alan Casper.
Traffic.
Tom Rivers, New Jersey. Traffic north.
Lorraine Rinaldi, New Jersey. Traffic south.
News.
Nick Alexander, New Jersey.
And Dominski and Dorr.
Being on an amusement park ride is stupid.
It's fun.
Well, it's stupid.
It's fun.
I really don't get it.
It's a thrill.
What's the point of spending good money to be spun around and get off at the exact same spot where you got on?
It's kind of like drinking, you know? You don't drink to the point you pass out. You drink till you feel good.
Dominski and Doyle. New Jersey 101.5.
Attention, tri-state homeowners. It's summer. Fix-up time again.
That's right. I have to take off that plastic we put up to keep the cold out every winter on our old, worn-out windows. All the windows are stuck. I have to lean outside to clean them. The screens are ripped and the bugs are coming in. I can't take it anymore.
Yo, Adrienne. And I have to paint them.
It's time to buy new windows.
Let's call our famous U.S. Window Factory.
1-800-965-6490. U.S. Window Factory, where you buy four windows and get the fifth one free. Plus, we'll give you $59 free. Each of your old windows. Think about it. 10 windows, $590. 20 windows, $1180. Call 1-800-965-6490. We manufacture and install beautiful bays, bows, double hungs, casements, sliders, awning windows, and patio doors. And they're all easy to clean. 1-800-965-6490. U.S. Window Factory guarantees their windows for life. Get free shop at home service, a free gift with your estimate, and no money down financing is available. We manufacture, install, and guarantee. It's time you called U.S. Window Factory. 1-800-965-6490.
How would you like to save 50 to 90% off original Spiegel catalog prices every day? Well, now you can. Every time you shop at Spiegel Clearance Center, you'll save an additional 50% off the lowest ticketed price. Yes, every day. Now you don't have to wait for a sale. They have a huge selection of women's and men's fashions, as well as home items now reduced an additional 50% every day. They receive new shipments direct from their warehouses every week. You never know what you'll find. A designer dress, blazer, or maybe a new ceiling fan for your kitchen. And best of all, they'll take an additional 50% off the lowest ticketed price at the register. That means you save a total of 50 to 90% off their original catalog prices. In addition to fantastic savings every day, now through Sunday, come in to register for prizes and Spiegel Outlet gift certificates, so don't delay. For best selections, get to Spiegel Outlet Clearance Center and don't forget to shop often. You never know what will be in their next shipment. Spiegel Clearance Center, located in Franklin Mills, Philadelphia, PA. Not valid on prior purchases. Intermediate markdowns may have been taken.
Freehold Jeep Hyundai has just solved your car buying problem, but only for a short time. You can acquire a new or used factory warranted car or truck for only a $29 acquisition fee. Pay only $29 and just make the payments on the car of your dreams. At Freehold Jeep Hyundai, you can own or lease a fabulous new car or truck, late model used, barely driven demo, company car, lease expired vehicle, or even a pre-owned 4x4 for the unbelievable acquisition fee of just $29. And just make the payments. But hurry. Time's a-wastin'. Choose from Jeep, Ford, Dodge, Honda, Toyota, Nissan, Mitsubishi, Hyundai. Practically every make and model. Don't miss this $29 opportunity at Freehold Jeep Hyundai's $29 acquisition sales event. Time is not on your side. Hurry for the best selection. Credit problems are no problem. Pay only $29 and just make the payments at Freehold Jeep Hyundai. Call now for complete details. 732-780-2900. Plus tax, tags, and registration fees with approval by primary lender. See Weekend Asbury Park Press for complete details.
You know, I'm sitting there playing with my hair. I usually keep it up. And I'm sitting there, and every time I comb through with my hands, I've got like a handful of hair in here. And I'm wondering from the stress, it must, you know what? It's the fault of the jet skis that I'm losing my hair. Can I sue the jet ski? I mean, my hair is my crown and glory. I'm sorry. It's long and it's thick and it's dark. And it's you young jet skiers that are causing me to lose my hair prematurely. That's it. I'm going to die prematurely. In the first time in my life that I've been healthy, functional, and happy, I'm losing my hair. I'm suing. That's it. I'm suing somebody. New Jersey 101.5, instant weather, changeable skies and humid. Watch for shower or thunderstorm, 90 to 95. That's stressful, too. Chance of an early shower or a thunderstorm, then clearing, 65 to 75. Saturday, much less humid with some sun, highs in the 80s. And Sunday, sunny with moderate humidity, 85 to 90, but lower near the ocean. Right now, Spring Lake is 80, Parsippany 80, Toms River 83. Next New Jersey weather, 10 minutes away on New Jersey 101.5, serving Atlantic City and Cape May on 97.3 FM. Look for the New Jersey 101.5 Big Yellow Van this summer as it cruises the Garden State. Sponsored by Cool Cow, all-natural, low-fat milk. Cool Cow, Cool Cow, Cool Cool Cow, Cool Cow, Cool Cow. That has got to be the best jingle of the summer. I'm sitting in the car. I'm singing it. Anyway, we're talking about jet skis, and actually, this was horrible. I mean, a 13-year-old died yesterday afternoon, had a head-on collision with a 14-year-old on a jet ski. Why? They got too close when one was going to hit the other. One cut the engine, which is the worst thing you can do, because when you cut the engine in a jet ski, as I have just learned, but I'm going to make it sound like I've known it for years, of course, you lose power. You can't steer. And it's like, right in there, dead instantly. One of the kids was celebrating his birthday. Yeah, that's really fun. So, under 18, I'm saying no jet skis. I'm not saying that it would solve every problem, nor am I an alarmist where I'll say, you know, oh, look, this kid got hurt on a mountain bike. You've got a banned mountain bike. That's horrible. The kid, he scraped his knee. Oh, my God. No, I don't believe that. But I think you would definitely lessen accidents. And any parent who lets their little kid go on a jet ski alone is not only an idiot, but an accessory to potential murder. Michelle from Washington Borough, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, Roberta.
Hi, sweetie.
I can't agree with you more. Kids, half the kids in the state don't even know how to drive a car at 17, and now you're going to let a 13 and 14-year-old get on a jet ski? They can't have a driver to like
13 or 14-year-old, the guy who called earlier had his 9-year-old do it, and I saw a kid last week in the Delaware that looked to be about 10 years old, alone on a jet ski, no other jet ski around, no parents around.
No way, not in a million years. I have two kids, one's two, one's a year, forget it.
You know,
I just drove one for the first time, and I'm 30 last week.
What was it like? I've never even been on one because I think I'm too scared, I have to admit.
Well, my first reaction was to, like the guy said, I cut off the engine when I went too fast, and you have no steering after that.
Right.
That was my first reaction. And then you have to think about it and say, wait, I want to steer, so I got to pull up the throttle a little bit more. So it's not your first reaction to hit the throttle to get out of the way of something. Like in a car, you're not going to hit your gas to get out of the way of something. You're going to hit your brakes.
Right. You know what? That's a good point, because that's the first thing you do is hit your brakes, and most people would have that reaction. And kids, even though they don't drive, so they aren't used to that reaction, young kids, first reaction would be to stop something, because that's what kids do. Jim from Tom's River, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Well, I have a 34-foot cruiser, and we go out to Barnegat Inlet, and we see these, I call them water gnats.
What? You know what I call them? I call them the lawnmowers of the sea, because that's what they sound like.
They come running out over our wakes, and they cross our bows, and I've had them disappear, you know, in front of my bow.
Wait a minute, Jim. The bow's like the front of the boat, right?
The front of the boat.
Okay, I don't want to be an idiot.
I've almost ground them up, and, the problem is people think water is soft. But when you hit water at 60 miles an hour, it's pretty hard. And they should be wearing helmets. They should be wearing some chest protection gear. And, I mean, the guy with the 9-year-old, he should be shot himself. He's got to be a total moron.
But the thing is, I know he fooled me. He sounded so lucid and so balanced. And then he said that.
I want him to get his jet ski cranking at 60 miles an hour and jump into the water head first and let him feel what it feels like. And then maybe he might change his mind as to it could snap his kid.
Well, you know what, Jim? How about, you know, in terms of protection and chest and headgear, how about the protection for somebody like me who goes tubing on a river, or a swimmer that's at the shore, or somebody in another boat or a non-motorized boat? We need to be protected from them.
I think there should be designated areas where they're allowed and not allowed. I think they should not be allowed in shipping channels, in major arteries. Because it's incredible. You get these morons that are out here, and they're jumping around 95-foot boats.
Okay, and can I add one? They shouldn't be allowed in crowded, narrow rivers.
Oh, definitely, definitely.
I mean, crowded. I mean,
anywhere there's tubers or people, they should not be allowed within 100 yards.
I mean, because I see this all the time, and you've got, like, up on the Pennsylvania side in North Jersey, there's Point Pleasant Canoe and Tube, which is a great place, and they bring, like, I mean, hundreds of people go tubing and kayaking and canoeing. No place for jet skiers. I absolutely agree. It's 10:49 at New Jersey 101.5, and right now, here is Fast Traffic.
Well, right now, the Parkway northbound coming in through exit 139 Union with an accident. It's off on the shoulder of the road. Multi-car crash here. Police, also a tow truck on the scene. So look for delays northbound on the Parkway in through exit 139. On the turnpike, you're going to find minor delays southbound at Interchange 5. That's because of right lane construction. It's going to be out there till around 1 p.m. Also southbound 295 in through Sweetsboro, an accident involving a couple of tractor trailers. Only the left lane is open. Delays aren't too bad. Voorhees, southbound 73, an accident at Crescent Road. Also, the eastbound Whitman Bridge, slow on the upside with construction. Westbound Ben Franklin Bridge, a little slow coming in through the tolls. Hudson River Crossing in good shape. New Jersey Transit SEPTA trains running on time. New Jersey fast traffic every 15 minutes around the clock. I'm Jay Trelease. Next report, 1103 on New Jersey 101, New Jersey 101.5.
New Jersey traffic is sponsored by Somerset Nissan in Somerville. Genuine Nissan parts are only used by the pros at Somerset Nissan. Expert service and Saturday hours, too. Call Somerset Nissan for an appointment. Toll free, 1-888-22-NISSON. That's 1-888-22-NISSON. Put your 9-year-old on a jet ski. Gee, why don't you take your 9-year-old, put her in the front seat of your car, drive your car in the garage, close the garage door, and take a hose. And take the hose and put it in your tailpipe, one end, and put the other end into the car in the window, and like let the kid die a more peaceful death there, you know? Greg, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Hi.
Hi. Just a quick thing for your listeners. I'm 42. I've had a jet ski for, I guess, 5 years. And I think the parents have to ask themselves if they would allow their child to get on a motorcycle and ride in traffic at 9 years old. These machines were designed for pure speed. I mean, I'm a responsible guy. I've got a 14-year-old daughter that I've let ride occasionally. I damn near killed myself. These things are designed for power, speed, and radical maneuvers. That's, you know,
you know what, Greg, and I've also noticed that, you know, this isn't the first time I've talked about this particular issue, and every time, you know what, the people like you that are older and more responsible and know what the hell they're doing are the ones that yell the loudest against the other jet skiers that are just jerks and troublemakers, because it makes all you guys look bad.
I'm a snowboarder as well, and you should see the looks I get, and I'm a pretty responsible snowboarder, and they've kind of ruined that too, but these machines, I've got a very responsible A student, 14-year-old daughter. I taught her how to ride this thing in Back Bay. I'm from Ocean City, Maryland. And she, when I'm around her, and she's very responsible and this and that, but I let her go on her own, and you would think that the devil came out in her like you can't imagine.
But see, that's the thing. I don't think you should let her at 14 ride alone. I think you should be with her.
I agree 100%. She's history. When I saw her do it herself, that's the thing. As far as with parents is concerned, they don't realize that when these kids get on, something changes, because you've got power and you've got speed. The brochure.
Wait, you know why, Greg? Most parents have never been on personal watercraft.
Absolutely.
They buy it for their kids. They've never been on it. Thanks for the call. Joan, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, how you doing?
Okay, Joan.
I own a house down the shore. I've got a lagoon in the front, and I've got Kettle Creek in the back. I have these...
Wow, I bet that's a beautiful house. I want to live there.
Oh, you're welcome to come down. I have these 10-year-olds. I have these 16-year-olds coming in the lagoon doing about 40, 45 miles an hour. I go out, I scream at them. You should hear what they say back to me. I tell them, you don't slow down. I'm going to take your number, and you are going to go. That's it. We have children on paddle boats. Do you know what a paddle boat is, huh?
Yes.
Okay. I mean, they crash into these paddle boats. These are... responsible parents letting their kids out on this paddle boat.
Joan, non-motorized things, whether it's a kayak, a canoe, a tube, a paddle boat, whatever, and any kind of fast motorized watercraft, like a personal watercraft, do not belong anywhere near each other. I agree with you 100%.
They come in that lagoon doing about 90 miles an hour, and they go out with open cans of beer. Okay.
Yeah, but the thing is, wait a minute, Joan, when you say, if you're going too fast, I'm going to take your number, if I was that little punk kid, I would just tell you to go to hell, that's swear at you, and then give you a fake phone number if you ask for it. I mean, you know, what can you do?
Yeah, well, if you take their number, you know, and you get the police, what are they called,
Coast Guard or whatever the heck, the Jersey State, you know, I don't know, the guys in boats, cops in boats.
Certifications away from them, and they can take their numbers off of it.
Yeah, but that's going to be hard. What you need to do is, and this is probably illegal, so you don't have to take my advice, get a BB gun, and don't put BBs in it, but anytime you see these kids come around, just take that rifle, put it on your shoulder, and go, if you don't get out of here right now, I'm going to blow your head off.
No, you know what I wanted to do?
What?
I want to put this thing underneath my dock. It's called a heat-seeking missile. And every time they do, just let one heat-seeking missile go.
There you go. Just spoke. Good for you. Oh, you're even more violent than I am. Good for you, Joan. Yeah, Joan, go. Thank you. Tony from Forked River, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Yeah, how are you?
Hi, hon.
Yeah, I was involved in that incident in Bayville. I just want to set some facts straight.
Yeah.
I guess you were talking about a 9-year-old. I hope that wasn't in reference to this incident.
No, no, no.
Okay.
No, these were 13 and 14 years old.
A little later, so.
Yeah.
Number one, it was a freak accident. Tragic as it may seem.
Oh, we know it's a freak. I mean, I know that that happens. I just
want to say, use a little tact. The families are grieving over this, and people are hearing this, and people are very sad. They are very dangerous.
Yeah, I know people are sad and people are grieving, but Tony, let me tell you something. Why didn't they just shoot? Why didn't they just shoot their own kid in the head?
Child abuse.
Yes, it's child abuse. Why didn't they just shoot their own kid in the head?
You're trying to get ratings out of this.
No, no, Tony, if you've listened to me at all, let me tell you something. I'm not bombastic or going nuts for ratings' sake. I've never done that. I'm only angry about things that I'm genuinely angry about in my heart and my spirit. I'm not a good actress, and I'm not a good liar. And I'll tell you something, Tony. It is child abuse of a sort to let a child that young go out in a jet ski, and I swear on my dead father's grave that that's the way that I honestly believe in my heart.
You don't have to swear, but I'll tell you this. It's the law, okay? The law says you have to be certified. These children were certified to drive. I'm not saying, I don't agree with jet skis. I think they're very dangerous myself. The law has to be changed. Number one, full race and shoulder restraints with helmets, okay? That would prevent this accident. But I just ask you, please, the families are grieving. There's much pain.
Yeah, and you know what, Tony? I know that there's pain here, but I'm going to tell you something.
Okay.
Tony, I'm going to tell you something, too. I think that we need to sit here and not act so tactful about this so that other parents wake off up their big, fat butts and stop committing child abuse with their own kids by putting them on a jet ski. I'm sorry. I'm sorry the kid is dead, but it shouldn't have happened.
New Jersey 101.5 presents more summer family fun in New Jersey.
Hey, this is Big Joe Henry inviting you to join me in New Jersey 101.5 for Sunday Family Fun Nights at Jenkinson's Pavilion in Point Pleasant Beach every Sunday night at 7:30 throughout the summer. Jenkinson's Sunday Family Fun Nights, sponsored by PSE&G's Worry Free Service. It's going to be a great night of big family fun Sundays at Jenkinson.
Proud to be New Jersey. New Jersey 101.5.
She was your fantasy. Sleek, fast, and fun. You could handle every curve. The heads she turned. And when you eased in behind the wheel to take her cruising, man, you really felt like somebody.
Hi, this is Don Tandler, the record handler of New Jersey 101.5's Saturday Night Jersey Oldies Show, inviting you to join me live and in person for Cruiser Night, brought to you by the Union Center Special Improvement District and sponsored by Kane University. Friday, July 17th, from 6 till 9 p.m. on Morris and Stuyvesant Avenues in the township of Union County. Bring your classic cars or come out and see over 100 other classic and vintage models from the past 50 years. These are the ultimate dream machines, guaranteed to get your motor running. Hot wheels and hot summer nights, what could be better? Don't miss it. Cruiser Night this Friday, July 17th from 6 till 9 p.m. on Morris and Stuyvesant Avenues in the township of Union County. For more information, call the Union Center Special Improvement District at 908-851-4666. 908-851-4666.
Riders, welcome aboard Steel Force at Dorney Park. Please fasten your seatbelt and secure your lap bar. Hold on.
You're in my hands now. I will launch you 200 feet into the air, higher than a 15-story building. I will hurl you to Earth at 75 miles an hour, faster than any coaster in the East has ever gone. I will wrap you in 2,000 tons of twisting, turning steel track with more thrills than you've ever experienced in your life. I will take you to the limit.